I'm Elisa with Scripts and Scribes. We are at the 2015 Stan Lee Kamikaze. We are with Mike Wellman.
Hi, how you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Fantastic. We got like one more hour of Kamikaze. I don't know what I'm going to do after. I'm going to be like, all my friends are gone. They, you know, I'm here by myself now. No, I'm good. Oh, good.
Yeah.
Oh,
you've got each other.
I'll be here.
Yeah.
Yeah, we do.
We do.
We got each other's backs.
What is going on?
Well,
tell us what's going on.
Today at Kamikaze, we have, if you look up here, the Comic Bug Pavilion, which is hosted by the Comic Bug, my store with June. And we teamed up with Regina. She helped us out on Free Comic Con Day, which was last May. And I was like, how can I repay you? How much do I owe you? She's like, why don't you curate a pavilion for the show? So that's what we did. We have like about, I don't know, 25 of our favorite artists here and friends. Cuddly's here, which is a dating app website. I just became a corporate sponsor. They sponsored me a phone, because it's on the Android, which I have an iPhone. Anyway, long story. Who else is here? The
You're
Defective
Geek.
Yeah, I have an Android.
Oh, congratulations.
Yeah. I'll show you. Then we're here promoting Guns Ablaze.
Okay, tell me about that.
Issue 3, the newest issue, just came out a couple months ago, which is like recent in Guns Ablaze terms, like most comics are monthly. But we do it when we can. This is the culmination of the Gunpowder Tour. We started early September, we hit Nashville, we hit Oceanside, we went to, where else did we go? Ohio.
Ohio, man. San Francisco,
San Diego. Oh, yeah. We were everywhere. We did a live karaoke event at Golden Apple.
All right.
Our friends the Thirsty Crows played at the one at the Comic Bug. I like to, when we do an event, kind of bring the book to life. So we had a cave girl hang out with us.
Okay.
We had rock bands play, and because like, here's the worst thing when you go to a science. Like, no, we want to rock.
Yeah. Wait, now you publish yourself, right?
Yeah, uh-huh.
So can you tell me a little bit about that world?
Yeah.
Do you publish for other writers, artists? Other
not really. I did once. I did the Kids of Whitney High, which was a real rock band, special ed rock band, and it was too good of an idea not to do it.
Wonderful time too. I had a great time working on that project too.
Yeah, it was so they wanted they played shows, they tour, and they wanted to do a comic book. It was their idea to do it, and I was like, that's a great idea. Let's do it.
Yeah,
so I sat down with each of the 8 kids that were in the band and developed the story they wanted to tell, and then I pulled in people like Rafael Navarro and Chuck Beebe, who's right over here.
Yep.
And Jim Mahfood, a lot of the Kids of Whitney High guys are,
Jim did the cover too.
To make the book happen. It was awesome. It was a really cool experience.
Okay, so having done incredible things, what would your advice be to somebody who's looking to break into writing comics, getting published? What kind of steps can they be taking to help advance their career?
Start doing it is the best thing. Because I know that's like the cliche thing that people say, but seriously, until you do it, you don't know how it's done. You're going to make mistakes. Don't worry about those. Just keep going. Perpetual motion.
Yep.
And then when other people see that you know how to do it, then they'll take notice and then they'll start asking you to do it. Because that's what everybody wants. Everybody wants like, I want my brilliance recognized. I want somebody to come and ask me to,
Everybody's looking for a cookie cutter like recipe on success. If I do this and do that and do that and I add some water, I'm going to be a millionaire. It doesn't really happen that way. You just, I see more people literally just going on certain financial gain programs.
Like crowdfunding and stuff?
Yeah, crowdfunding. I don't want to give any plugs to any other crowdfunding programs out there right now at the moment. I see more of those people literally looking for reassurances as opposed to just taking a chance. And if you think your idea is bold enough, go out there and go for the gusto. I mean, the worst thing that's going to happen is that you'll fail. And what happens, failure is not a bad thing. It's a learning process. You learn to get back up, Bruce Wayne. You learn to do the next project even better because of it. And that's what people are afraid of. They're afraid to take chances now.
Everybody.
Well, I make sure that whoever I do run into, youngins and whatnot, to make sure they always have the courage to reach for the stars.
I love that.
Yeah.
I love it because it's so true. Just have the courage to get out there and start doing what you're passionate about.
Yeah. I mean, I guess, what Raph's trying to say is too, like people want a safety net. So like, be it like they want that validation before they do it. You have to do it and then you get the validation.
I want to prove that my mom and my dad that what I do for a living is actually like, feasible because, it resembles the stuff I was growing up with as a child. No, look, be an adult, be responsible, but do not lose the heart of the child in you, man. That's the cool thing. I mean, look, yes, it's wonderful that anytime I buy a book or a comic book, anything, movies, that's a tax write-off. But, dude, I mean, I still pay my taxes nonetheless. You know, you got to be a grown-up, but at the same time, you know, keep that smile going.
So true.
You know,
especially when it looks like that.
Look, see, look. If I always had a Xena in front of me, I mean, my smile will always be eternal, see? But, you know.
That is one of the reasons we do this.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Well,
they
clearly.
Two Xenas.
Obviously. No, I love your guys' energy. It's amazing, and it's very inspirational, and I think that's incredible advice for our viewers is just do what you're passionate about and keep the heart of it. You know, do the work, but keep it going. You know, keep on moving forward. So
perpetual motion.
Yes, perpetual motion.
And one more piece of advice. You know, take a look at your community and engage with your community and support your community. Your community supports you. So we've got, like, the artists and writers around here. Just a great community of people that we see each other a lot and help each other.
We support one another. We have each other's backs when the time comes and vice versa. And that's always a good thing. You know, you can't raise a comic books alone on just, you know, one parent. You need an entire village to do that. So
yes.
So start building your village and get to work.
There you go. I love it. Here's the shaman of the village, Richard Starkings. What?
And we are
Shaman.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. I'm on it.
Anyway, we'll talk to him. You should talk to him. He's great. I don't know. Maybe you already did.
I don't know. Yeah. We're with Scripts and Scribes.